What's up guys, and welcome to day 59 of the 100 days run streak challenge. My name is Jeremy, you're on the marathon experience, and today we're going to talk about one of my favorite vegetables, which is broccoli, and three different ways to cook them. Let's go. Broccolis are extremely good for your body. They are full of fiber, antioxidants, minerals, and vitamins, especially vitamin C. Vitamin C is extremely important for your body. As the NHS explains it, it's helping your cells to protect them and keep them healthy, as well as maintaining a healthy skin, blood vessels, cartilage, and bones density. And it helps a lot also with wound healing. But enough talking about broccoli and all the good things that it can bring to your body. Let's talk about how can we cook this in three different recipes that I like. The three recipes are either steamed broccoli with eggs or a velouté with broccolis, which is basically just a thick soup. Or third, broccoli in a wok with some noodles and other vegetables. Let's start with steamed broccoli with eggs. This is a perfect recipe if you don't have a lot of time and you only want to spend 20 minutes tops in order to cook dinner or lunch. We've used it a lot with Margot, especially because Margot is super good at doing poached eggs, and that goes very well with steamed broccoli. The first recipe is steamed broccoli plus poached eggs. So first, you're gonna clean the broccoli, cut it, and put it into boiling water. It will take approximately 10 to 15 minutes to get the broccoli soft and ready to eat. While the broccoli is boiling, you can prepare another pot and wait. When the water is boiling, then cut off the heat, break some eggs in it, and leave them exactly 3 minutes. The tempo is really important here. If you leave them for more than 3 minutes, you're gonna end up with different type of cooking of eggs probably. Then you can take the eggs off, same for the broccoli, when they're both done. We usually add a little bit of soya sauce on top of that, with some red pepper as well, but that's all based on your own taste, so feel free to add whatever you like to this recipe. And that's all done. It's a perfect meal, very healthy, a lot of nutrients, you got some protein there, and everything that the broccoli is bringing as well. It's a perfect lunch or dinner. Second meal is a velouté with broccoli and beetroot. For this, you can prepare the broccoli the same way we prepared it for the previous recipe, by just cleaning it, cutting it, and putting it into boiling water for 10 to 15 minutes until it's soft. While it's boiling, you can probably cut the beetroot and put them in the blender. Wait for the broccoli to be done and add those broccolis with the beetroot in the blender. Blend everything. You can also add some boiling water with vegetable growth boiling on the side while the broccoli are being prepared, and add that into the blender as well, just to give a little bit of taste. Once you put everything in the blender, blend it for a few minutes, and once it looks like a thick soup, that's ready to be served. It's the perfect meal for the evening as it's pretty liquid. It's gonna stuff you very well, but it's gonna be extremely easy for your body to digest. You'll sleep well, you don't have to put a lot of calories that you can't burn because you're going to sleep. That's a perfect way to eat with low calories and a lot of nutrients in the evening. Third recipe is to put those broccolis into a wok with protein noodle. Those specific noodles have a very low amount of carbs and a quite high amount of protein. We usually add to broccoli and protein some carrots, lemon juice, oyster sauce, onion, garlic, and also miso paste. Margot is a big fan of Asian cooking, that's why she uses a lot of rice vinegar, oyster sauce, soya sauce, miso paste, or ginger in her cooking. She finds all of those ingredients into a local Asian shop, which is also extremely cheap and adds a lot of taste into any food you like to prepare. That's why you'll find a lot of those Asian tasting food in most of the recipes that I put up on this channel. First step to prepare the wok of vegetables is to first put some onions and garlic into the wok. Make them cook with some oil. It could be coconut oil, olive oil, or sesame oil. You can add to that a little bit of rice vinegar, some soya sauce, and also the juice for one lemon, and make it all cook for 5 to 10 minutes. At the same time, we're gonna make the carrots and the broccoli boil together for a few minutes, as well as preparing the noodles as explained in the instruction of the noodles. Once the carrot and broccoli and noodles are all ready, throw them into the wok and let the whole thing cook for a few minutes, and it will be ready to serve. That's it guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, and let me know in the comment if you've ever tried one of those recipes and if you enjoyed it. And also, if you have some other recipes to share about broccoli, go ahead and put them in the comments so we can all benefit from it. Let's now move on to the run streak update of the day. Today my weight was at 78.6 kilograms, which is slightly going down since the vacation we had a few days ago, where I didn't really eat healthy. Hopefully everything will go down in the next days. Regarding the run of the day, I tried today to go on a trail, and I found some amazing trails just around our place. It took me a little further than 10k, it was more around 12.5k, so around the 7 miles mark. In a total of 1 hour and 15 minutes. My pace was slightly slower because I got a little more elevation, and also on trails, you don't run as fast as on the road. But overall, it was really beautiful run. I got to see some sheep, some very nice green fields. It was really a lovely run. By the way, if you are joining the channel right now, I am in the middle of a 100 days run streak challenge where I run a 10k every single day. I also upload a video on YouTube every single day about tips, advice, recipes, also a feedback about this 100 days run streak challenge. So if you want to be part of the journey, go ahead and hit subscribe, hit the notification button, and I'll see you tomorrow.